Previously on Lost.
You stole my kidney.
You needed a father and I needed a kidney. Get over it.
Are we still on course?
We're still heading north on a bearing of 305. Yes.
I'm sensing a lack of confidence.
We've been walking for 2 days, following a compass bearing provided by the carvings on a stick.
And?
You really think we're just going to chance upon where the others are?
I don't know what we're going to chance on, Saeed, but my bearing is the only bearing we got.
Amo, vuoi controllare la posta?
Sì.
I'm going to find some food. And then, John, we're going to have a rational conversation regarding our next move.
I've been in Milton Keynes since the start of October.
I lived near the university in my first year and I moved to Stony Stratford in my second year, which is the north end of Milton Keynes.
11 months.
1 year almost.
1 year and a half.
Oh, Jesus, 4 years ago?
This is my fifth year in Milton Keynes, yeah. I'm originally from Barbados. And I've been in the UK altogether for 6 years.
I arrived here in October 2006, so I have been living here for 7 months or something like that.
I've lived in Milton Keynes for about 8 years.
I'm a student here at OU and I've been in Milton Keynes for about 2.5 years.
I have been in Milton Keynes now for more than 5 years and I have to admit, I knew almost nothing about Milton Keynes before I came here. But immediately after I arrived here, I was given a student's guidebook which helped me acquaint myself with Milton Keynes.
I knew very little about it, apart from the fact that it was there. It was a new town, I knew that much. I had heard rumours about roundabouts. Rumours which proved well-founded, that there were a lot of them.
I took a ferry in the north of Spain, and I arrived here, in Portsmouth with my car. So then I drove from Portsmouth to Milton Keynes. 30 hours, 1 day and a half, more or less. Well, the thing is that I was really sick because of the strong winds and the sea. And when I arrived here, I was really in really bad conditions, but well, I could manage to drive my car. Well, dark, raining, and lost, and roundabouts. When the sun is
pronto. Sì. Sì. Non ancora. Sì. Sì. Ci stiamo lasciando? Sì. Va bene. Ciao.
Lot of information, but the problem is that the information were not so right. But anyway, no, it's not true. They were right, but they gave another impression of Milton Keynes, actually.
Well, I did get the package from the research school that tells us all about Milton Keynes, so I read that up, and all it really said was that we had a lot of roundabouts, concrete cows, a ski slope, and it was the newest city in the UK.
Well, there was some advertisement booklets about shopping in Milton Keynes, and I think about cultural life, like about theatres and nightclubs.
Got a sense of what was maybe in the place, in that you kind of realise, yeah, there's big shopping centres, there's cinemas, there's leisure facilities. But yeah, it was a sense of what was there rather than a sense of the place.
So it's demonstrating a perfect Milton Keynes, which is not the case.
Well, it was pretty useful, but I don't think that it was really prepared me well to the impression of Milton Keynes.
I mean, they described it in described it on MK Web as a town like none other in Britain. Which is a very, can be very double meaning.
I was at York before I came here, and York is a very traditional UK town. So Milton Keynes was a little bit of a shock when I saw it. I had not expected to see roundabouts and buildings like the US, this kind of stuff. I just assumed all cities in the UK look the same.
On the first day, actually it was on the first evening when I arrived for the interview, I just went out of the train station and, you know, it was completely empty, there was nothing. So I just decided, okay, let's take a cab. So I went into the taxi and I told the taxi driver, please, to the city center. And the taxi driver looked at me like, yeah, this is the city center. So, you know, I just couldn't believe it.
The first impression was actually the openness is like, you know, you're just looking and it's not like other cities where it's all the buildings are right around you and it's very close. So that's my first impression. This is, you know, what is this very open space?
We drove around a lot of different areas looking at small one-bedroom places, and our impression was, yeah, lots of roundabouts, lots of kind of suburbs, strange housing, all sorts of different housing. Yeah, very different from what we're used to.
When I was a kid, Milton Keynes started up. You know, I was about, well, I was 40 years old, so I was about six when it started up. And so it used to be on the news, and then there was that famous series about birds with the red balloons all going up and saying, come to Milton Keynes. And then there was really lousy press coverage of Milton Keynes, making it sound a very boring place. And, you know, it was seen as the place you wouldn't want to go in the whole of the UK, really.
I was missing the people. You know, people on the street, there was nobody, everything was by car. It looks like you just see countryside, you don't see the houses or anything at all, and you just see the shopping center. So my impression was a bit like this wasn't really a city.
During the night is the only time of the day that you can see people walking out in the center, which is really nice, and it's really something that is missing from Milton Keynes.
Obviously, in a traditional town, you'd have a part of the town you could think, right, this is the old town, this is where it started out from. So a new town, you kind of felt, well, everything will be in grids, everything will be very much planned from day one. There'll be facilities here, houses here, this is going to be the commercial district, this is going to be the business district, this is going to be residential district, this is going to be shopping district, and so on. Nightlife. You have the same type of clubs and pubs that you'd find in any other British city, but you don't have anything else.
I think pub culture is an important British thing, and the city centre doesn't do it. It doesn't have proper pubs. I mean, it has chains of restaurants and cafes and restaurants, but it doesn't have the kind of unique pubs. You can go for a drink in town, but it's a very different experience. Maybe that's just more exciting for some people. I think for me personally, the music isn't my style, and so maybe I would go if there was a club or a bar that was solely kind of my kind of music, but I don't think there's enough of a range.
Can you film us?
You know, there's more to Milton Keynes than you see from the road, and it was a lot greener, and you could tell that they put a lot of planning into the trees.
All the pictures that used to go out on the news and things were from the time when it was really new, and they'd just planted all the trees, and the trees were little tiny trees, and you looked, you know, it's like fields with little manky little trees in them. But now you come and it's green everywhere, especially at this time of year, you know, everything's coming to life. And, you know, all the work the Parks Trust does to make it green, it's fabulous now.
Yeah, it's a city, but you still have the country with it.
It's fantastic. I'm really happy with all the green and squirrels. I have never seen squirrels in my life in Greece. So I'm going out from the house and I see squirrels everywhere. It's really nice.
Especially throughout March and April, when we had that very fine spring weather, it was extremely nice to see everything suddenly coming into bloom. And it is very green around here, and it can be pleasant just to walk around the place, and you can get away from the main roads as well. So there is kind of a pastoral feel to it.
I remember we found Woofton on the green, and we were like, wow, but this is in the middle of Milton Keynes, and that was really strange. But we did think, well, this is nice, you know, places like this in Milton Keynes. And whether you would argue that that's not the real Milton Keynes, because these places, the villages, are really old and were always there. But if you do include them as Milton Keynes, then they're really nice, and it's good that they've preserved those villages with the fields around them. But, I mean, actually, I think there's more villages than I even know about. Since living here, like, every few months, maybe, I have to drive somewhere and you find a preserved old village, like, or old farm, like Shenley Farm End. It used to be a farm, and, like, the Bradwell Abbey area has, like, an old abbey and farmland.
I mean, I cannot describe Milton Keynes just in general or in absolute. I can give my impression, so it's very related to my experience in Milton Keynes. But I would say that is a place that, like, put yourself in a very difficult environment, so, like, test yourself and your ability to adapt to a lot of difficulties. And the nice things of being here and of overcoming these difficulties is that, in a sense, you, like, the city at some point start giving you something.
Are you sure it's completely isolated?
I've circled the house. There's nothing but jungle surrounding it.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you work here?
Yeah, I do.
I'm looking for somewhere to stay until I find something in Milton Keynes.
Of course. I'll get you the form. If you follow me.
So it's like you overcome, you work, and at the end you are more concentrated on other things, like the important ones. So, for example, because you don't have many distraction, you are much more concentrated in social relationships. So it's much easier that you build a very nice friendship, and you think more about the other people in your same situation, so at the end you ended up helping them as well as other people helped you at the beginning.
Here it is. Where are you from?
Italy.
It's a long way. When did you arrive?
Yesterday.
Probably want a smaller room, though, if you're staying for a while. Although the 9-bedroom is free at the moment and you could move later.
I'll take the 9-beds one. I need to go. Can I leave this here?
Sure. When you come back, as will I. Oh, by the way.
Yes.
You're very handsome.
It takes time to like it, but you like it in the end. The most important thing is the people.
There's all sorts of people, international, all sorts of religions and faiths. So I think you can find like groups and communities, but I think perhaps you've just got to look for them a bit harder.
There is no feeling of pressure. You don't feel like one in the crowd. Yes, I definitely like it.
I mean, perhaps you don't want to go somewhere and have to learn this, but, you know, you find friends and you make a kind of good time of it. And so I don't think Milton Keynes, like, has, like, great nightlife. And I think some cities have a much better vibe and character as a whole. But it's a new city, and I think in maybe 30 years' time, it'd be really interesting to see whether it's developed a character. So I think if you're going to come here, yeah, it'll be fine.
a place where you can explore more of the quiet, self-reflecting life. Whether you stay here for a short time or for life, I'm sure you'll find it a very different place.
Come and see it.
I'm looking for some biscuits.
I leave an option.
I'm looking for somewhere to stay until I find something in Milton Keynes.
Of course, I'll just get you the form.
No.
I know, it's odd. Of course, I'll get you the form. Why?
I think that's it.